Shepherd. He was a very wise person. Yes. To he thought to himself, I need people like him to work for me. So the king he told Shepherd that he needed the persons who were wise like the shepherd. Yes, Shepherd he was a wise man. So king he wanted wise person, wise people to work for him. So for that what he did? And the king Okay, of money that collected as the tax of the from the people. Why did he always carry with him? They added an iron chest. So the shepherd, he used to carry a iron chest, iron box with him. But so for that, what they told? Why the shepherd, he always carry a iron chest with him? If suppose he is not a, keeping the money with himself, then why he is always carrying the iron chest with him? So they went on adding bad things about the shepherd. Okay, see, perhaps he carried in the treasure that he had secretly collected. So why they perhaps probably he maybe he the shepherd he maybe against the shepherd. They said mockingly, yes, they were mocking him, they were satirizing the shepherd. So started satirizing, satirically, in satirical tone, in mockery, they were talking about the shepherd. He was an ordinary shepherd and would behave no better. So take you. parchment and even of the king himself. When the chest was opened, no gold or silver or jewels but on but an old blanket was all that came out. Holding it up proudly, the shepherd said, "This, my dear master, is my only treasure. I always carry it with me." See here. So one day what happened? One day the king, he noticed that a new governor, he is always carrying the iron chest with him. So for that, the king now he called, he sent a summon. Summon in the sense call. So he called the shepherd to the palace. So when he was summoned, the shepherd, when he was called to the palace, he came on his camel. So now the shepherd, he has become the district governor. So he came on the camel. So on the camel, when he came on the camel, then also he carried the iron chest with him. Okay, the iron chest was with him. So shepherd, he came to the palace. One day he came to the palace and king, he saw the shepherd having or carrying the iron chest on his camel's back and giving the security to it. So the king, he came very angry. In anger, king said him that, asked him that, "Why do you always carry that iron chest with you?" The king asked the shepherd that why had he carried the iron chest everywhere and what it contained. What the iron chest it contained? The king, he asked to the shepherd. So then the governor smiled. So now the governor, who is the governor here? The shepherd is the governor here. The governor, he smiled and asked his servant to bring in the chest. How eagerly the people standing around wait for a shepherd to be found out. So when the king, he asked the shepherd the iron chest, what it contained. So then the shepherd, the governor, he smiled and told his servant to bring the iron chest in the palace. And when he told his servant to bring the iron chest in the palace, all the other governors, all the people who were waiting there, the shepherd's insult. They wanted to know what the iron box it contained. So they all were eagerly waiting. So when they were waiting, what happened? But how great was their astonishment. See what they have. They had the thought that the shepherd is collecting the treasure in the iron box. But when the iron box it took into the palace, palace, they were astonished, they were surprised. that iron chest there was no gold. So no gold was there, no silver was there, no jewels. Jewels were there, but the iron chest only it contained a old blanket. The shepherds used blankets. The only a old blanket it the iron chest it had. So by seeing the shepherd said, "This, my dear master, is my only treasure. I always carry it with me." So when the iron chest was opened, there was no gold, there was no silver, there were no jewels, but the iron chest it contained a old blanket. That blanket was held by the shepherd, and he showed the blanket to the king. Shepherd he showed the old blanket and told that it was the only treasure of him. Then the king he asked the shepherd that why he always carry a ordinary the blanket. It was old and it was ordinary. So why he used to carry the ordinary blanket? Why? Because he was now the shepherd. He was a governor of a district. So a governor. King asked the shepherd. So the shepherd, to which the shepherd replied with quite dignity, "This blanket is my oldest friend. I will still protect me like if at any time your majesty should wish to take away my new chokes." See, yes. When the king asked the shepherd that why he carries always that ordinary blanket, so then the shepherd he with quietness, with peace, with a dignity, he replied to the king that the old blanket was the oldest friend of him. The blanket was the only oldest friend of the shepherd. So it. The blanket it protects the shepherd in any condition. The king's majesty. Embarrassed, the jealous governors became to hear the wise man's reply. Now they knew that the shepherd was indeed the humblest and the wisest man in the land. The king made him the governor of a much bigger district that every very day. See, so now the king, he was very happy by hearing the answer of the shepherd. So all the other governors were also there, no? So all they became very shy. They came to know that why the king, he made shepherd as a governor, and they came to know about the wisdom of the shepherd. So then they agreed, they adopted the wisdom of, they agreed the wisdom, the shepherd is, they agreed that shepherd is a really a great wisdom, has had a great wisdom. And from that day, the king, he made the shepherd the governor of the big district. Then the governor, the shepherd, now he became the governor of big district. At the beginning he was made a governor of a small district, but now after this incident the shepherd, he became a governor of a big district. All the jealous governors, they agreed his wisdom, and they agreed that he is the wisest person in that